Patriots, what's up? It's Forgiato Blow. Look, I got a brand new song called Real America out. Thank you for supporting it. The link's down there. I did it out in San Diego with OAN at their studio with Dan Ball. Shout out Dan Ball. Listen, I think these indictments are going to backfire immediately. We see everybody coming out, all different races, all different colors, all different people in America right now standing tall with Donald Trump. A lot of people are relating to him because his corrupt justice system has did the same to them. So I think it backfired. Fannie Willis, she made a big mistake, but we should hire you as a campaign director over here or to raise money for the Donald Trump campaign because you made us about $8 million so far.
You just heard from MAGA rapper Forgiato Blow, who is obviously a big fan of Donald Trump. He was promoting his new song, Real America. And while we unfortunately, due to copyright purposes, cannot show you the video that they put out, we do have some stills and some lyrics to share with you all. So the self-described mayor of MAGAville's new single is basically him fuming about the most recent criminal indictments against Donald Trump. And he's doing so in the OAN newsroom, the network that has been dumped by nearly every cable provider in the United States. Now let's dissect the song and the music video. So the song shares its title with the primetime OAN show hosted by Dan Ball, Real America. Dan Ball is prominently featured in the video and also introduces the song with a monologue about how patriots are fed up because Trump has been indicted for the fourth time by the corrupt Biden regime justice system. Okay, and it appears that there were some staffers who were not notified about the filming of this music video, and more importantly, did not want to participate or be shown in the music video. So they got the hell out of there. We'll get to them in just a moment, but first a few fun screenshots featuring a very goofy Dan Ball. Mm-hmm. He looks hard, doesn't he, Cenk?
Yeah, I don't wanna think about how hard Ball is or Blow is.
Now in the video, Forgiato Blow is walking through the halls of the network and interacting with the staff, some of whom do not wanna be included in any of this. Trying to make it seem like he actually has a job there, other than being, you know, a rapper who's trying to film a music video. Then he shows a manila folder with a Trump indictment on it. Dan Ball, meanwhile, dances awkwardly to the beat whenever he's not holding up an American flag. And then here are some more screenshots. There we go. There we go. There he is with the American flag.
And they ripped that envelope at several different spots in the video. They ripped different envelopes with different indictments because that'll show them.
That'll show them.
And you know, I've listened to rap my whole life. And what rappers are most famous for is ripping envelopes. And so that'll show you how hard they are. But you know, it takes two to make a thing go right. So if they become a rap duo, they could be Blow Ball. And that could be interesting. I watched the whole thing. I had the misfortune.
You watched it?
Yeah, of course I did. Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Me too. In researching this story, I know it so very well. I can't stomach it. It's too.
No, I think it's hilarious.
I feel embarrassment on behalf of others, even others that I disagree with, and so I just couldn't put myself through it.
100%. That's why some of them literally ran out of the building. I noticed his hand actually says "lost soul" on the fingers, and then it kind of made me feel bad for him, like. Brother, that's pretty on the nose. That's kind of exactly what you are, a lost soul. But what I like about the story is the right wing, they love to criticize black culture, anything to do with the left, etc. But they secretly are desperate to be cool.
Yes, they want to jump in it.
Exactly. Yeah. And they secretly love it, but they feel bad that they're not cool. And so they do goofy things like this.
Let's take a look at Dan Ball. I mean, you don't think Dan Ball's cool? He screams cool.
Is he ballin'?
I don't know. I don't know anything about Dan Ball. Nothing.
I've never heard of him in my life.
I've never seen this man in my life.
Literally both never seen him or never heard of him. And then the staffers are like, oh, that's another typical Dan Ball stunt. I was like, really?
He does stunts?
Who is he?
The whole point of stunts is so you can like get your name out there. I've never heard of him. But anyway, just some fun lyrics from the song itself. In the land of the free and the home of the brave, there's an Air Force veteran that's trying to pave the way. Prince of primetime, I spit the truth like I'm Dan Ball. Real America, OAN, we ain't no commies, y'all.
Wow, that's powerful, man.
Father and a journalist, he never changed for the fame. 30 years later.
That dude's been doing journalism for 30 years. For 30 years? Jesus. Okay, good for him. He looks young.
30 years later, Dan Ball's legendary man, get real, read between the lines, FJB middle finger to the other side.
So that's one of the things that they think is cool. They keep saying read between the lines and putting up three fingers.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, okay, I've seen it.
What is that about?
The middle finger.
Oh, read between the lines. Okay.
I have seen it before from third graders, literally. Like when my kids were in third grade, they're like, mama, read between the lines, I hear it's not in school. And they have it in their super cool and super hard rap video.
So Forgiato Blow also uses the song as a time to rail against Democrats, calling them pedophiles, yada yada. Same, you know, far right stuff. But it wasn't just Dan Ball who made an appearance. This is my personal favorite part of the music video, which features another individual. Okay, so this is OAN founder and owner Robert Herring. He made a cameo. Mm-hmm. Here's a still frame of that part of the music video. Yeah, real hard. And who's that guy in the background with the bulletproof vest?
His lover.
No, don't say that.
I'm kidding. It's apparently his security. Sure.
Okay. So here are the lyrics that are rapped as that part of the music video is happening. Patriot like Mr. H, 82 years in this place. Liberals need a safe space, then burn a flag in your face. Put America first, like OAN, American News, abolish mail-in ballots. I love this part. So I know that we can't lose.
Yeah, less voting, woohoo, pro-America.
Yeah, prevent people from voting so we can win, basically. Or make it more difficult for people to vote so we could win. Like, that admission is incredible.
You must be so proud. And it, you know, but I have to tell you, if I had a nickel for every rap that had an anti-mail-in ballot message, I'd have a nickel. I've never seen that in a rap or any other song in my life.
Yeah, super lit. Anyway, this song slaps. So literally all he does is like stand there, what a patriot, right? The founder of OAN. But let's now discuss the other individuals who did not want to be part of it. Now, some of the other anchors did participate, like, you know, the very famous and well-known Stella Escobedo, Alicia Summers, and Allison Steinberg. So they all made appearances. I don't know any of these people, which is a good sign.
Oh, definitely. Right? And in fact, a lot of the staffers complain about how this rap video makes them look ridiculous. No, this rap video is the first time we've ever seen you guys,
yeah.
Right? So, you know, to be fair to the blowball team, they did it. They actually got us to look at OAN for the first time in history. So, congrats.
And yeah, and some of the staffers, again, were not notified about it, did not want to participate, and felt that the entire situation was super cringeworthy. I need one unidentified current OAN anchor told the Daily Beast, I need to leave OAN ASAP. I am sick and tired of Dan Ball's antics, and so are so many others behind the scenes. Also, a former network employee who called the video unhinged and desperate quipped that whoever let news anchors and a newsroom participate was likely coerced. Other current and former staffers told Confider that they are officially taking OAN off my resume after watching this, or that they can't stop laughing at the bizarre video. It is kind of amazing that it's the cringeworthy music video that makes them question their employment at OAN. I do find that fascinating.
Yeah, I mean, OAN sued for lying massively on air, it pretty much nonstop. Like Newsmax is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, and even they look down at OAN. Okay, it's just absolute nutty place. But this video is the one that puts you over the top. But you know, look, I don't know. I'm not going to speculate on that. So, because I was saying maybe they don't like the idea of rap.
No, I don't think that's it.
Probably not.
It is super cringy, Cenk.
Oh, of course.
Everyone likes rap, okay? All of you, everyone does. Even when you say you don't. Okay, California Love comes on. California Love. Don't tell me you don't like that song. Okay, don't tell me that when Biggie comes on, right? The radio or Spotify, wherever you listen to music, that you don't get super excited about it. Like, I like classic rap songs, you know, from the 90s the most. Not to sound like an old lady, but everyone's got at least one rap or hip hop song that they love.
Well, I'm mainly a Forgiato I Blow fan. Okay, but no, seriously, guys, I get it. A lot of right wingers love rap too, and like I said earlier, although they attack black culture, they want to be part of it because they think it's cool. But no, I'm sure there's some right wingers who are uncomfortable with it. But you're right; that's why we retracted it. The main thing here is it's so cringe, and I'm telling you, I watched it. It reminded me of something else that we did in third grade. No, that one was in fifth grade. We did we shot a little video in elementary school, and it had like a little punchline at the end. Somebody takes the wallet, and inside the wallet it says "Nana Nana Boo Boo."
No.
And this video reminded me exactly of that. And the funny part is they're grown ass men, and they think like that "Nana Nana Boo Boo" is like hilarious and hard. Mm-hmm. And so that's the difference.
One of my favorite lyrics from Notorious B.I.G. and it's just a throwaway lyric, I think, but for some reason I always think of it when I think of Notorious B.I.G. where he raps about having rough sex on rugs that's Persian.
Oh yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah.
And then what was the other one?
My favorite is Escargot, My Cargo.
Yes, yes. Cubans with the Jesus piece.
Yeah.
Wait.
Hit you up where you're working. Have sex on carpets that are Persian. That's
yes,
the line.
Yes.
I'm butchering it a little bit.
We are maybe. Butchering it. Okay, let's wrap this up because it's
wrap
speaking
it
of
up,
cringe.
If you will.
Yeah.
So, but to be fair to the OAN and the right wing, their cringe rap videos, and that's what they have, and we have my cringe dad jokes. So, pick up. Come on, you know you like this. My dad jokes are like rap on the radio. You know you like it. You know, don't you give me that face.
What face? You know, wreck it, buy a new one. Your crew run, 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 your crew run, run.
Anyway. You guys saw that in Word Magazine.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.